That time was lost, yet time continued onward. Divine Etro, go peacefully to your rest. I will stand guard over your legacy. This endless realm is awash with sadness. Life and death lose all meaning under the rolling waves of chaos. Valhalla, the currents of time do not touch its shores. In this world of lost moments, I begin my life anew.
This eternity, it was never your desire. Is that not so? You... Warrior Goddess. Now we cross swords! Lose yourself in battle and rejoice! Embrace the terror. Of the Wandering Comet, I summon thee! Impressive.
Save it. Damn you.
Enough. Let's end this. Cast your shadow over all! Wings of Night!
Odin! Not kidding around, huh?
Goddess made a wise choice. Powers of chaos bend to my will. Keeping up?
So you want to destroy everything?
Oblivion is the fate of all things. Now it's my turn.
Come and die.
We shall see.
Of course, the one from the vision. I know your name. Noel Kreis.
What? What in the...
I'm here!
Where am I?
Valhalla. You prayed for a miracle, and that brought you here. Or am I wrong?
How did you know?
From Valhalla, I can see everything.
But who are you?
Lightning.
What now?
Gonna get worse. I never said I was a goddess.
How do we fight him?
This is not your battle. There's something else I need you to do.
What?
Bring my sister to me. Her name is Sarah.
Okay.
You'll need to use the portal. Your time-gazing friend should have told you how it works.
That's a gate? But why me?
Because you're the only one who can. You crossed the void and made it to Valhalla. You can find Sarah. And together, you can change the future.
Wait. I can change the future?
Yes. Good luck, Charm. Give him to Sarah.
Right. You got it. I'll track her down. What's happening?
Enjoying your little chat.
Caius?
Get to the gate. I'm counting on you.
Okay.
Go! Not this again. Odin! Do it!
Gotta go!
go with you, Noel Kreiss. Become an arrow through time, and speed your way to Sarah. Be there for her, because I no longer can. Time flows without pause. In a world where I no longer exist, the future is about to change. Truth still survives, but only you remember it.
Lightning. She was fighting. I guess it was just a dream.
Save it for later. Can you fight?
If I have to?
You're gonna have to. One more thing. Don't ever lay down and wait to die! Hey, Sarah! Are you okay?
Yeah.
Mackie!
Yeah. Gotta go.
Okay.
All right, everyone, listen up. The meteorite hit over there.
Right.
We're gonna check it out.
Team Yuge, ready to roll.
Well, and careful. That area's crawling with monsters.
So stay close. Come on.
Okay.
Right. You heard him. Move out.
With you.
You're okay.
She took a hit, but she's gonna be fine. She just needs some rest.
Thank goodness. And thank you. Whoever you are.
Noel Kreis.
Okay.
And before I forget, it wasn't just me. You should probably thank this little guy, too.
Is that a toy Moogle?
He's supposed to be your lucky charm. Your sister gave him to me.
Wait, you know Lightning?
Mm-hmm. She's the one who told me to come here.
Where? Where did you see her? Was it Valhalla?
Yeah, how'd you guess?
I saw it in a dream. I saw my sister. She gave you the Moogle. Then the meteorite came.
And dragged me along with it, I guess.
Do you mean you actually rode here on that meteorite?
Maybe. I don't know. Damned if I can remember. Why don't we go and check it out?
Okay.
Coco?
Now I know for sure. Lightning is alive. She's in a place called Valhalla. I'd only just met Noel, but I believed him. I believed every word he said. Even though it couldn't possibly be true. It seems like only yesterday. The smile on Lightning's face when she gave her blessing for Snow and me to get married. But I'm the only one who ever remembered that. No one believes. It's just a dream, they say, from when I slept in the crystal. An illusion. They say my sister is gone. That 3 years ago, she sacrificed herself to stop the fall of Cocoon. She turned into the crystal pillar that holds Cocoon above the surface of Pulse, and saved both worlds. That's what they say. But even so... Not used to seeing Cocoon, huh?
No. Well, actually, this is the first time I've ever seen it.
The first time? You can't be serious. Like, the first time seeing it from the outside?
Sarah! Still in one piece?
We're seeing lots of unfriendly critters around that meteorite. Uh-huh. Who's this?
Oh. This is Noel. He helped LeBro and me out of a tight spot.
Is that right?
Hey.
I'm Godot.
Okay, take it easy, big guy. I am not here to make trouble for anyone.
You better not. Anything happens to Sarah, the boss will string your carcass out to dry.
The boss? Who's that?
He ain't here right now!
Hey, Yuge.
Hey. So, this is the famous Noel, huh?
Yep.
I guess news travels fast.
The bro told me how you helped her out. I'm Yuge. Nice to meet you.
Hey, likewise.
What's with the new style and thread, Sarah? Not exactly a dress-up and hit-the-town kind of occasion.
If I told you they fell from the sky, you probably wouldn't believe me, huh?
Are you telling me the meteorite is a fashion critic? Okay, I better get going. See you guys later.
Bye.
Weird. How do these plants grow so fast? I don't get it. It must be pockets of unstable time or something.
More meteorite phenomena.
Oh, you got that right. Oh, look at this stuff. Ever since that rock came down, we've been seeing all kinds of aberrations.
Do you have any idea what's happening?
Not the slightest clue. Some spots seem to have sped forward centuries. But other parts haven't changed at all.
So, these areas are from different timelines. Realities blending together. Like two ages overlapping. That about right?
Right! It's exactly like that!
I wonder, did that meteorite come from another world?
Like another dimension or another time?
It fell here from Valhalla.
Huh?
Let's keep moving. If we learn more about the rock,
gone.
What happened to Cocoon? It's not there.
Well, you're looking at a different time. That's the world I come from. In my world, Cocoon doesn't exist. When I was born, the sky was already empty. Tell me, how many years has it been since Ragnarok appeared and Cocoon fell?
Well, it's 3 AF. So that was 3 years ago.
For me, all that happened 700 years in the past. I was born and raised in another time. 700 years in the future.
Yes, I knew it. I knew you weren't from this world.
I'm the last of humanity.
Hey!
Sarah, I can take you there. We can find Lightning together. I know she wants to see you.
You're full of it!
Yeah, that's impossible!
Lightning's gone, man.
Godot. Noel, do you know where my sister is?
Come with me.
What's happening?
You see? It's a time gate.
What do you mean?
Wow.
Time gate.
What the?
It's like a portal. Lightning is in a place called Valhalla. She's waiting on the other side.
I couldn't turn my eyes away. I knew the answer lay beyond that gate. The answer to my doubts and dreams. On the broad plain beneath Cocoon, my sister once celebrated my marriage to Snow. I remember her smile like it was yesterday. But sometime when I wasn't looking, she disappeared. She was gone as if she'd never been there in the first place. Lightning, are you out there? Did I dream that day on Pulse, or did it really happen? Noel says he can find you, but is he telling the truth? Noel's world was a terrible place where Cocoon did not exist. He had traveled back in time to change that bleak future, or so he told us.
Listen, when different eras overlap, all kinds of crazy stuff happens. Objects from different times get mixed up. If you want to open a gate and travel through time, you have to find one of those objects. They're called artifacts.
Artifacts?
The keys to the future. They're anachronisms, relics of a different world. Basically, things that don't belong in your time. If we can find one, we might be able to use it to open the gate. Then we could cross time and travel to Lightning's world.
Could Noel be telling the truth? Beyond that gate, in a place called Valhalla, is Lightning alive and waiting for me? Can I dare to hope again, after all this time? Oh, how I want to believe. I want my sister back. So much happened the night the meteorite fell. We all had a lot to think about. I wonder if anyone slept.
Sarah, wait up for me.
All this talk about artifacts and gates and time travel, to be honest, I don't know if I'm ready to believe it.
Sarah, there's still so much I don't understand myself. If we can actually find an artifact, then I'll know what I've been saying is true. And once we open the gate, you'll be able to put some of your doubts to rest as well. So what do you think? Will you search for the answers with me?
Lightning.
I met her for the first time in Valhalla. I thought I was done for, and when I called the goddess's name, she appeared. Is your sister some sort of deity?
Of course not. She became a Lassie and turned to crystal. She did it to protect Cocoon. What?
Is that the artifact?
This is Lightning's knife. I keep it in my room, but how did it get out here? Hey, look there. Snow!
Sarah!
Come on.
Okay.
It's her knife. I found it near the base of the pillar.
Snow.
Sarah, I'm sorry. She must be inside the pillar. Lightning's holding up Cocoon, along with the nail and flame.
Wait, what are you talking about? She was right here a second ago. I saw her. We talked. She gave us her blessing. Forget that moment. Lightning was happy. Happy that Snow and I were getting married. She laughed and said congrats.
Sarah.
But then,
Sarah.
All of a sudden, lightning disappeared. She was gone. Like she was never there to begin with. No one else remembered her smiling and laughing. No one but me.
All your friends think your sister is inside that pillar.
I was scared. People said I was dreaming. They said I was just making up stories so that I didn't have to face the truth.
Listen, Sarah. Your memories are the truth. Lightning is alive. The question is, why are you the only one who remembers?
Perhaps I saw a different future.
You're talking about another possibility. A world that might have been.
Does such a world exist? A place where my sister is still alive? Weird. The knife looks like it's been... What is an artifact, anyway?
No one knows. Only that it's something that doesn't belong in this time.
Did someone in the future tell you about gates and artifacts?
Yeah, but now all I have is memories. I wish I'd thought to ask more questions while I had the chance. These disturbances are all happening in the area around the impact site. I'd say our best bet is to search around the town. Oh, wow. You grow vegetables?
What? You mean you don't?
Well, the soil is barren. Nothing will grow at all. We have to survive by hunting. It's that or starve.
Yesterday, you said you were the last of humanity. What did you mean?
Just what I said. When I was born, there were fewer humans in the world than live in this village. After a while, I was the only one left.
How did it happen?
There were monster attacks and illnesses. People die. But everyone said the same thing before they passed on. The future is yours.
Snow, so this is where you got to. And the artifact isn't here, huh?
Snow?
Koopal?
Oh, yeah. She's my pet.
Koopal?
Huge found her and brought her home.
Hey! I don't see why not.
I think we should keep her, too. Just as long as she doesn't make a mess in my workshop. Hey, Colonel.
Are you sure you can look after her?
Can't we all do it? I mean, we are one big family, right?
Yeah, right.
Mac, you'll do it.
You too.
Thanks. She's adorable.
She really does have a face.
I thought I could hide it from them, but they knew. They saw right through me. I'd lost Lightning, and then Snow. But those guys, they really tried to cheer me up.
Oh.
So it hasn't been all bad.
No, not at all. Life is harder here compared to back on Cocoon. But everyone sticks together. Even in the tough times, we have each other. That helps.
Those friends of yours are like family, aren't they?
Yeah. Yes, but it's only part of a family. It just doesn't feel whole without my sister, you know?
If it's what you really want, one day you'll be together again.
These are my students. I teach their classes.
A school teacher, huh?
Right!
I'm so glad you're all safe. Yeah. Now, did everyone do their homework?
I did mine, because I didn't want you getting mad at me like the last time.
Seems like you'd be soft on kids, but you're pretty strict, huh?
Hey. Not that bad. Come on. You know, I'm only strict because my teacher was strict. Lightning must have rubbed off on me.
My grandmother was a teacher, too. She taught me everything I know. She taught me about Grand Pulse and its history.
What was your grandmother like?
I was always her favorite. She kind of spoiled me. She lived until she was 50, so she had a lot to teach me.
50? But she was still so young.
Lifespans were longer during this age. If my grandmother were still alive, I could have learned so much more. I could have handled things better.
That's the kid I was looking for! I knew my eyes weren't playing tricks on me!
It's Mackie! I better get out of here! Miss Farron?
Why did you run away? I promise I won't get mad if you tell me.
I know you say you won't get mad at me, but I can't tell you. I don't want to get yelled at.
The kid was trying to get away from Mackie. I bet you anything he was up to no good.
You were running from Mackie, weren't you? Did you do something you weren't supposed to?
I was watching him work on the robots. And then I saw it, and I just couldn't help myself.
This ought to be good. And then what happened?
I hope you're not misbehaving. It makes me sad when my students don't behave.
I'm sorry, Miss Farron. Yes, I'll own up. The truth is, I sold something from Mackie.
And that's why he was chasing you?
What did you take?
This necklace. It belongs to you, doesn't it?
Hey, wait!
What was he doing with this anyway?
That belongs to Mackie, doesn't it?
No, it's mine. It's a reminder of a promise a good friend made me.
Sarah, I believe you. Your sister's alive. She's out there somewhere.
Thank you, Snow.
Here. You hang on to this for a while. When I come back, it'll be with Lightning. Then there's no way she can say no to us getting married.
Okay.
Okay.
And that was the last time I saw Snow. The memories I had of Lightning standing on the plain beneath Cocoon. He was the only one who believed. Believed them enough to do something. That's why I've been waiting here.
And doing nothing, right? Lightning and Snow are long gone, but you still sit here and wait. Why didn't you go after them?
I have faith in Snow. He is a hero, after all.
And has that faith been enough? Neither of you want to be apart, yet here you are alone.
Don't you think I know that?
Sorry, I shouldn't have said that. But you tell me, what good is a hero if he's never around?
Hmm.
No artifact yet, huh?
No, instead, my things are showing up in places they shouldn't be.
I wonder if someone's trying to mess with us.
I doubt it. No one here would do something like that.
I guess not. Unless they think they're doing the right thing.
It might not be a person at all. I mean, with time and space being warped everywhere, anything could happen, really.
Right. And that's how your things ended up out here? It's not a bad theory. Okay. So maybe we should ask if anyone else is missing stuff.
Let's head to the house and find out.
You know, I was thinking, if Noel here really is from the future, he must be pretty curious about this time period.
That's true. We should probably explain a few things.
I'm all ears.
We were all born and raised on Cocoon, but 3 years ago, our home basically fell out of the sky. We couldn't rely on the Broken Foul Sea anymore. So, most of us made the decision to move to Pulse.
Weren't there millions of people living on Cocoon? It must have been pretty cramped.
Well, it was. But on Pulse, we had to deal with new hardships, like vicious monsters and a lack of provisions.
Sounds like a rough time.
Yeah. But eventually, things settled down, and some former military types helped get things organized. Now there's a growing town at the base of Cocoon's pillar. The guys who used to be in charge are long gone.
How did you end up in this place, then?
Our leader, Snow, suggested we live somewhere near the ocean. We used to live in a seaside town on Cocoon, so it was like we were rebuilding our home. Snow and the rest of us were used to fighting monsters and getting our hands dirty. So we pretty much settled back into our old way of life.
Snow's not around right now, so we do the best we can. But if Lightning were back, everything would be so much better.
So for everyone here, your sister being gone is the reality. Odd. Hey, check it out.
Wait. Okay, what is that?
Koopo? Koopo?
How did that happen?
It's a twist in time. Something that doesn't belong.
Yeah.
I think this is an artifact.
We found an artifact, just as Noel said we would. Does this mean everything else he said is true? Did he really meet Lightning in Valhalla? Maybe. Once I step through the gate, I'll be leaving my friends, my students, and the village for who knows how long. Can you tell me, Lightning? Do I dare believe this man?
I'm going to take this artifact and open that gate. But you still don't trust me, do you? I can see it in your eyes. If there's anything you're wondering about or don't believe, just ask, and I'll try to explain.
Well, there is one thing. What is it you want, exactly?
A future that has people in it. I lived at the end of days. I was the very last child to be born. As I grew up, everyone I knew died, one by one, until eventually it was just me. All their dreams fell on my shoulders. I was their last hope. It was too much, so I left. Sure, maybe I couldn't go home again. Maybe I couldn't make everyone happy. But at the very least, I could rebuild a future where everyone could survive. So I went through the gate. I wasn't thinking very clearly then. I had a dream, but I didn't think it all out. I didn't know what it really meant. But once I got here and saw how you and your friends live in this village, I knew my dream could come true. In Valhalla, your sister gave me a chance. She gave me hope. The future can be changed. That's what she told me, and I believe her.
I understand. Thank you, Noel. Thank you for telling me that.
Ah!
Are you sure you're ready? You know, once we go through, there might be no coming back.
Yes, I'm ready to go. It's not a dream or a lie. I know my sister is alive out there. I'm sorry I doubted you. Of all people, I should know how bad it can make you feel when no one believes what you say. Snow put all his trust in me. Now it's my turn to do the same for you. I've made up my mind. You and I, we go together.
I won't let you down. We'll find Valhalla, I promise. So, you're not gonna say goodbye?
There's no need. We already have, sort of.
Be quiet.
Lightning's knife. It's been sharpened and cleaned.
You did that.
Hey, shut up!
Look, my pendant has a brand new chain.
Mm. Shh. Okay.
And Snow was purring like a kitten. Someone gave him a good brushing.
Quiet.
Hey.
Why don't you guys go fess up?
What?
Go on. You too.
Hey, Sarah. I figured no way you're leaving the pendant behind. So I made a chain, you know, so you wouldn't lose it.
If Lightning is alive out there, wouldn't want her getting mad over a poorly maintained weapon, you know her.
If you leave, someone's gotta pick up the slack looking after Snow, so I volunteered myself.
Thanks, guys. It's time for me to go. I don't know what's waiting out there, in the future, between worlds, but I want to see Lightning so much. If there's any chance at all, I want to take it.
You can go, but you have to come back in one piece. Promise?
I promise. If I believe, maybe a miracle will happen.
The future won't change until you make the first step.
You know what you're doing, right?
Well, I can't say that I do. This is the first time I've opened a gate myself. Guess we'll just have to find out.
Hey, what about Sarah?
I'll protect her. I promise you, I vow never to let her come to harm.
To don't.
But
trust me, for Sarah's sake. Let the future starts now.
I'll be back.
Sarah, you set out on your journey for my sake. You believed in a promise. You believed in a future you could not see. I will keep fighting here, at the end of the world. I know you will come. I believe in you.
Sarah.
This place is incredible.
It's the Historia Crux. The crossroads of the time continuum.
So this is how you were able to travel backwards from the future?
Right. Just floated through this nowhere space. And now it's your turn.
When reaching for the future, we sometimes fall into the past. As we gaze upon events that cannot be changed, our hearts grow bitter with regret. And you, my dear Sarah, will you encounter your past here? How will you choose to deal with that pain?
Sure?
Yeah, check it out. You can see the ground above us.
Oh, wow. So this is how Cocoon looks from the inside.
That's right, I forgot. This is your first time here.
Yep. Exciting.
Guess it's over. Huh? It's the army!
Kubo! Well,
friends of yours?
Attention intruders! Surrender immediately!
Kubo? Kubo?